You know, I have to give it to the Toronto Police Department up there because they go to all lengths to get their man. Apparently, there was a Canadian smuggler that was coming through customs there, and they caught him on bicycles. It's like, you guys not have cars up there? I'm just wondering.
Yeah. We have them, but why?
No.
Don't you guys have chips?
I was surprised you guys didn't capture him on a horse. That would have been just as funny. Now, Montreal Police Commander Miguel Elston and Cat K Cafon Sincada. That's easy for you to say, Connie.
With the pronunciation. Nice work.
Yes, yeah, she keeps my pronunciations in check. I just play with it myself. Apparently, these two were sitting on a park bench preparing to smoke marijuana at a joint with another man when police approached them and began to question them. Elston said the officers were not satisfied with the answers after he produced identification that turned out to be a fake driver's license from Maryland. Then they tried to take off, and they took off after him on foot and then along a bike path, but officers caught him, arrested him for suspected drug possession, fingerprinted him, and then revealed his identity. Now, the best part of this article here is the great job in pushing the investigation. They had a feeling he was not who he said he was. Doesn't that always boil down to that with cops? It's like,
got a feeling.
I just had a tingling. His horse sense was tingling.
I wish it had been a Mountie on horseback and that the villain had the name Snidely with a mustache, because my childhood, you know, bucket list would have had another notch in it. That would have been awesome.
Yes, that would have been exactly awesome.
Dudley Do-Right died, though. So.
Oh, did he? Uh-huh. He lives forever in my heart.
Please don't let anybody let Trump find out that this guy got a fake ID down in Maryland.
They're all Mexicans.
Yeah, don't let them know that you caught him on a bicycle. Otherwise, the police department down here everybody would be on bike then. Not that I would mind all that, Mike, really.
Well, Trump would assume that everybody in Maryland is Mexican then, and that they're all riding stolen bikes.
Yeah.
They're all bad hombres.
Was it, I'm trying to think, was it Maryland or Vermont where they had that governor who says they're all coming up here from Mexico? They got muscles the size of cantaloupes because they're carrying drugs across the border. I forget who said that.
It's hard to remember because neither one of those states matter.
You're right. I don't live there. I don't care.
I hear Vermont and I think maple syrup, I guess. So, I guess there's that.
I was going to ask, was the drugs maple syrup based? I'm just saying, you know.
We actually had a huge maple syrup heist up here that was worth millions of dollars.
Yeah, I remember hearing about that. Yeah. I remember hearing about that.
That's our crime.
We covered that here in the show a while back.
Yeah.
That was awesome.
Yeah, you guys get heroin and mass murders and school shootings. We got people stealing fucking syrup.
I know, right? That's some sticky hands.
That's a very sticky hands.
We should be building a wall.
I've said we should have a northern wall just to keep the cold air out. You know, you guys can keep that shit.
I just don't know how we're going to get Mexico to pay for it.